Hello, how are you doing? Changing Life Ministries, House of Prayer, family and friends, and everyone that is tapping into this small recording. We are excited for what God is doing in your life. We are excited for today. We pray that you are enjoying your time with your family, your friends, and with your loved ones. And we declare that this year is going to be the greatest year coming up of your life, and that God is going to be doing some great things in your life if he's not doing them now, which I'm quite sure he is, because we serve a great God that does great things all the time. But I do want to encourage you to let you know that within the birth of Jesus Christ, there's a promise that I just want us to focus in on to help encourage us. It's something that's very, very, very intricate, something that's very detailed that we have to take a look at. And it's this, and it's found right here. Look at this. In Matthew chapter 28, verses 18 through 20, the word of God says, "And Jesus came and spake unto them, saying, All powers is given unto me in heaven and in earth. Go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and the Son and of the Holy Ghost, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you." And then he says this, and this is so important to catch, and this is so encouraging, because within the birth of Jesus Christ, this promise right here is fulfilled. Let me show you. It says right there at the end of Matthew chapter 28, verse 20, it says, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I commanded you. And then he says, "Lo, I am with you always, even until the end of the world. Meaning that being a child of God, being in God's family, God made a promise to us that he will never leave us nor forsake us. That means no matter what you're going through, no matter what good times, no matter what bad times may be going in your life, God has made a promise through Jesus Christ that he will never leave you nor forsake you. Now, I know some of you might be scratching your heads thinking, okay, what does that have to do with the birth of Jesus Christ? Well, within the birth of Jesus Christ, this promise is fulfilled. Let me prove it to you. And this is so exciting. When I came across this, it made sense, but it made greater sense. And the reason I say that is because we know this to be true, and the scriptures say it to be true, and we're familiar with these things. But when it comes to light for us, and when it comes to light for us, it's a beautiful thing. Look at this. And if we take a look in Matthew chapter 1, and take a look at Matthew chapter 1, verse 20, it says, "But while he thought on these things, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared unto him in a dream, saying, Joseph, thou son of David, fear not to take unto Mary thy wife, for that which conceived in her is of the Holy Ghost. And she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins." Now that right there is a beautiful promise, and that's a promise that we definitely need, because we understand that it's in the name of Jesus that all men are saved. There is no other name, absolutely no other name under heaven whereby men must be saved, and that name is Jesus Christ. And the beautiful thing about it is that if we call on the name of Jesus Christ, the Bible says, you shall be saved. There is power in the name of Jesus Christ. What kind of power? There's saving power. There's keeping power. There's delivering power. It's Lord, I need your help power. Lord, I need a healing power in the name of Jesus. Any and everything that we need is wrapped up in the name of Jesus. But more importantly, salvation is wrapped up in Jesus Christ. That the angel said, listen, I need you to give him a name that's going to identify what his purpose is. And that name is Jesus. Why? Because he shall save his people from their sins. If you are looking to be saved, if you are looking to go to heaven, if you are anticipating to wanting to spend your life after death with Jesus Christ, there's only one name that you could go to or call on to be able to be saved. When I was young and I realized that I needed a savior, I called on the name of Jesus Christ, because there's no other name whereby men must be saved. But he says that she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins. Now, I'm going to get into what I really wanted to encourage you with today right here. He says, now, all this was done, that it might be fulfilled, which is spoken of the Lord by the prophet, saying, this was prophesied years ago, years before Jesus Christ was born. It says in verse 23, behold, a virgin shall be with child and shall bring forth a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which being interpreted, God with us. Let me say that again. You shall call him. They shall call him. I could call him Emmanuel because that means God is with us. God is with us through our good times, our bad times. God is with us as we celebrate, as we suffer loss. God is with us as we get ready to cross over into another year. There is nothing that you could do to cause God to not be with you at any and every moment of your life. So I want to encourage you within the name, which by all men must be saved, Jesus Christ, that God is with you at all times. There is nothing or no place that you could do or go to that will keep God from being with you. If you happen to go into the heavens, God is with you. If you happen to go through the wilderness, God is with you. If you happen to go through the valley of the shadow of death, God is with you. If you happen to be in a fire, probably with Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, I guarantee you that there'll be a fourth person in that fire. And that fourth person, everyone will look and say, kind of look like it's Jesus. Why? Because Jesus will never leave you nor forsake you. For this Christmas, I want you to understand, realize, and embrace the fact. Yeah, I know. This year may have brought you a whole bunch of ups, a whole bunch of downs, a whole bunch of ins, a whole bunch of outs. For some of us, life just put us in a whirlwind over the last year or maybe two. But I want to remind you that God is with you. And when at his birth, God wanted to make sure that we understood that as we give our life to Jesus Christ, as we make him our Lord and Savior, as we decide to follow him, to allow his life to be lived in us and through us by accepting Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior. He says, I will never leave you nor forsake you. So times when you may be feeling alone, times when you may be feeling down, times when you may be feeling like you can't go forward or you don't want to go forward, always remember that God is with you. Let me repeat that one more time. Behold, a virgin shall be with child and shall bring forth the son, and they, or should I say you, shall call him Emmanuel, because God is with us. I want to tell you that we love you, tell you Merry Christmas, enjoy the time with your family, and never ever forget that God is with you. Man, Merry Christmas.